don't have to open the mouth mirror at all. By only talking with the patient, you should be able to come at a diagnosis. Then you will come at a stage where you don't have to talk to the patient at all. You can make the diagnosis. Okay? First, history, proper history. If you take a proper history, almost all the diagnosis you can make. Just to confirm our diagnosis, you are taking the next step. Okay? The next is visually seeing. Checking everything, seeing everything, not missing anything. Then you are using, in general medicine they will be using to palpate, auscultate, this thing. But we are doing three pieces: percussion, palpation and probing. Three pieces, remember this. Okay. We may be doing percussion and probing, but people are not doing palpation. Right? Not regularly. So we'll discuss these things in detail. Before that, we have to understand why a patient comes to a clinic. Why a patient comes to a clinic? Have you thought about it deeply? Sacrificing your sleep, sitting in your bed, or standing in your upstairs. Why a patient comes to a clinic? What may be the reason? If you want to be a great doctor, you should be doing this. You should think deeply. Why a patient really comes? When a patient really comes? For what all reason the patient comes? Okay? When you think like that, you will get a lot of answers. Okay, what answers I got is, almost 90% of the patients, what you are getting is pain. So pain is the main thing. So we need to diagnose the pain aspect. Okay, many times, almost all the time, we are forced to make a diagnosis for the pain. Other things are minor. Swelling, food impaction, bad smell, halitosis, for ortho, aesthetic reasons. For what else? Bleeding, gum bleeding, gum bleeding. This is it. Okay. But only for pain is the main reason. So our diagnosis class today is focused mainly on the pain. Almost 90% of the patients who come to a clinic, any clinic for that matter, they come for pain. Other things they can postpone. But this thing they cannot postpone. You understand one thing. I will tell you one example. You are having a hair loss. Okay, we'll go to clinic. We'll do. That's it. Have you ever thought of today? I have to make an appointment. I want to know what is happening. I want to take some. I want to remedy it immediately. 7 o'clock. I have to come in. No. Imagine you are having a severe back pain. You couldn't able to move like this. You couldn't able to move like this. You cannot concentrate. You cannot see the patient. You cannot talk to in the home. You cannot able to speak in the phone. You cannot able to do anything properly. You're fully disturbed. Then immediately you are searching, look for some hospital nearby, look for some orthopedician, get an appointment. Immediately you are going, immediately you are getting the treatment. Because pain is, pain, my teacher used to tell, pain is pain. Who wants pain? Who wants pain? Tell, who wants pain? Who wants pain? Who loves pain? Forget about it. Who wants pain? Nobody in the world wants pain. Nobody will ever tell, I want pain, please give me some pain. No. Well, they don't want pain. It disturbs you from top to bottom. Even though pain is only here. Even though pain is only here. Even though pain is only here. But it disturbs your full system. Even though the pain is arising from a physical aspect, it eats you in the mental aspect. Your day-to-day workings, day-to-day communication, routine work, everything is completely collapsed. You won't be able to focus on anything. This is a total damage. Then you immediately want to rectify it. Other problems you are postponing. So body uses the pain to push the human to get immediate solution. By other means you didn't react. You are dull and dumb. So final weapon is pain. The final weapon for the body to make you to do something for your body, to do some good things, to change your bad habits, to get some good habits, the body's final weapon is pain. Even after that, you resist or delay, then problems will. Okay. For example, there are certain people who delay even pain. They go to medical shop, they put medicine and they go away, right? For example, if you work in a government setup, you will see lot and lots of abscess cases, space infection, Ludwig's angina. But here we are getting only pain without swelling, right? Even swelling rarely we see. That means immediately patients are taken care of. If you don't take care of, then it may go into osteomyelitis, space infection, space problem. Okay. So when it comes to pain, you have to understand the impact of the pain on the psychological aspect of a patient, of a person. Then only you can approach the patient, in a good way. You have to approach in an empathetic way. Otherwise, where pain? Okay, pulpitis. You need oxygen. If you really understand about pain, then you will understand, you will approach the patient in a different way. Have you slept yesterday night? No, sir. Oh. Okay. Then when you are giving prescription, you will suggest some sleeping pills also. You want that? You will approach a patient in a more humanistic way. Okay. So the pain, it has got something little about the physiological aspect. It has got two things. One is site of pain, source of pain. When the patient is telling pain, we have to find whether the site and source are same or whether the site and source are different. So what is site, what is source? Site means where is the pain? Where the patient is telling the pain? The patient is telling pain in this hand. It is a site. But what is the source? The source is the heart. The site is there, but the source is there. So I fell down, I hurt my hand here, I am having a bruise here, I am having pain here. Pain, I am seeing a bruise here. Site here, source here. So there are two situations. The site and source both are same. That is one category. The site is different, the source is different, that is second category. The second category is called, is there any name for that? Referred pain. That is called referred pain. This is more common. This is more common. 80% of the dental patients, they will have referred pain. The only thing you have to ask them, little more conversation. Are you having pain, doctor? I'm having pain here, doctor. Are you having headache also? Yes, yes. With this pain, headache also starts. Are you having ear pain? Yes, yes. With this pain, this ear pain also starts. How many patients, they go to ENT first, right? Many patients you see, they go to ENT first, then the ENT refer them back, right? So what is the site? What is the source? When the site and source are different, then you are confused. Why all looks good? Why the patient is telling pain? How many situations, how many times you are in this? What all looks good? No caries, no perio, no gum inflammation, no pocket. Why the patient is telling? Why the patient is telling pain? Why the patient is telling pain? Have you thought about it deeply? If you want to excel in diagnosis, you have to do one thing. Before sleeping, you have to mentally go through all the cases and go through again. What I missed? I made a diagnosis, but what I missed? I didn't make a diagnosis, what I missed? I made a bad diagnosis, what I missed? Then only you can make a better diagnosis next time. If you don't go through this process, if you don't think what you have done on the day, then we will never grow. Okay. So coming to the referred pain, what are the various scenarios? The patient is telling pain in the lower, but there is no problem in the lower. The patient is telling pain in the 6. There is no problem in the 6. So what are the possible scenarios? One thing is, there may be an impacted 8 which is giving referred pain to the front area. That is one scenario. So the referred pain may originate from the same jaw. Okay, this is one aspect, this is one type. The referred pain may come to the patient may be telling pain in the premolar area, but the problematic tooth will be a 6 or 7. The patient won't know that, but when he percusses it, the patient will be telling, here the pain is. You got the point? So the referred pain may originate from the same jaw or the from the opposite jaw. There is no caries in the 6, but you see a huge caries in the upper 6. If you percuss it, the patient will be having pain, but the patient will be keep on telling, here I am having pain, but the problem will be in the upper. Many times it happens. The only thing you have to keep this in mind, look the upper, that's it. If you don't do this, then you cannot make a diagnosis. Right? And many times the sinusitis referred to the molars. The sinus pain referred to the molars. Previously, it is difficult to diagnose a sinusitis. OPG, you cannot diagnose the sinusitis very clearly. Okay, many times even healthy sinus, they look opaque. But when you take CBCT, the sinus is healthy. Because of superimposition of zygoma and all, it looks opaque. Opposing side superimposes, it looks opaque. We think sinusitis, but it is good. The only way to rule out whether the patient is having sinusitis or not is to send the patient to a ENT specimen. Previously, I am telling. But now you can immediately take a CBCT and immediately rule out sinusitis or not. Without CBCT, it is difficult to make a diagnosis of sinusitis because the symptoms both are same. Of course, there are some peculiar symptoms for natural sinusitis. The patient will be telling pain here, and he will be telling on bending down or climbing the stairs. But still, it is difficult sometimes. The perfect way is to take a CBCT and then refer to the ENT surgeon if needed.